So can you tell us what it means to receive this Walk of Fame star in St. Louis?
Well, you know what everybody's been asking me? You got the star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, and now you're getting the star on the St. Louis Walk of Fame. Equal. One made me, and the other one is what it made me. How about that? So, from whence I come, Kinloch, Missouri, St. Louis, Missouri. You guys molded me. Come on, I went to the Kinloch School District, went to First Missionary Baptist Church, where, you know, I sang my first solo, and that's where it all started. When I saw the reaction of the congregation, I stood there with my thumb in my mouth, and they were clapping and screaming and everything, and I never looked back. I said, oh, this is life, and I never looked back. I've been in show business ever since. And I've had an amazing time. I'm one of the lucky ones, Kelly, that I got to do what I love to do with my life. And extremely grateful for the journey I've taken. All of it, all of the thorns in the rose garden. I tell people the price for getting older is wisdom, and it feels good.
Talk about that journey, maybe encouraging a young person, try to get into the industry, to never give up.
Find your passion. You say, Miss Lewis, now, what does that mean? How do you find your passion? What makes you happy? What makes you happy? Go get it. I didn't say it was easy. A lot of people don't even know what they want to be. Make something up. Make something up. But get there. Do the work, because life is precious. You don't want to waste it. The trials and tribulations will come.
What does St. Louis mean to you to come home, to be with family, and to know that you're loved here now?
Well, it's comforting. You know, I'm all over the world. I've been very blessed to travel so many places. I mean, Antarctica, Mongolia, Easter Island, Egypt. I've been all over the world. That's what I do. That's what I love to do, is travel. And, but home. When I come home and am with my family, it's nothing like it. I know you heard about the accident I had in Africa. I wanted my siblings so bad. I was so far from home, but they were right on my shoulder. And I couldn't tell them. I could not tell them that their baby sister was in ICU in Nairobi, Kenya. What were they gonna do? I told Robin Roberts, fly down there and bring me flowers. The working title of my third book is Get Up. I was on the ground of the Serengeti, having fallen 10 feet into wild animals. Who even has that story? But I got up. Doctors Without Borders was right there. They flew me into Nairobi, 9-hour surgery, 6 days in ICU, a year and a half rehabilitation, but I'm back. I didn't know how not to come back. I say that in every interview. I never heard the helicopter when they air-vac'd me out, but what I never stopped hearing was my soul screaming, whatever this is, Jenny, my family calls me Jenny, whatever this is, Jenny, you'll come back.
Talk about that experience. It changed your perspective on life.
Absolutely. You know, I was doing okay before I fell. But when you look death in the face, you come back better. If you have the courage and the strength, I didn't say it was easy, but I didn't know how not to come back. I'm an alpha female. I'm Jennifer Lewis. You know, I get the job done. I don't know how not to. You're looking at somebody who was president of my class at Kinlock High School. I was successful in the theater department at Webster University. I got my first Broadway show 11 days after graduating from college. I went on to backup singer. I was a backup singer for Bette Midler. I started doing club acts. I was on Broadway. I did 4 shows on Broadway. And since then, concerts all over the world. You know, born and raised in Kinlock, that sits on the border of Ferguson, Missouri. And even as a little girl, I was warned never to go to Ferguson alone. But Ferguson had a movie theater and Kinlock did not. I would sneak over there on Saturdays, get my popcorn for 25 cents, and imagine myself on the silver screen. And now, 68 movies later, I didn't let racism stop me. And I say to the kids out there, don't let anything stop you from your passion.
Talk about that passion. You're known as the Black Mother.
The Mother of Black Hollywood. Yeah, that's the title of my first book, my memoir, The Mother of Black Hollywood. I gave up all the secrets, all of them. How I suffered with mental illness. I was diagnosed at 33 years old with bipolar disorder. The pastor of my church molested me. I dealt with a lot of addictions. There ain't no shame in my game. I believe that we are as sick as our secrets, so I have none. What are you gonna do? Did I say that was easy? No. Once again, the thorns in the rose garden. And I'm free. Far from perfect, but I'm free. I went and got help for my bipolar disorder. I learned tools to get through the horrors of life. I've used them, especially to rehabilitate from this near fatal fall. There were wild animals around me. Who even has that story? There was a lion roaring. What? And I joke that the king was about to eat the queen. Girl. But they came and got me. The doctors and nurses at Aga Khan University Hospital in Nairobi, Kenya, saved my life. And I want to thank them. I want to thank Doctors Without Borders for airvacking me out of Tanzania. It's been quite the journey, but I'm back. I worked very hard for a year and a half now, and there's a lot more to go. It still gets a little stiff and sore. I have to stretch a lot and still take care, a lot of self-care, because it's one thing you learn when you look death in the eyes, and in my case, taking my head out of the lion's mouth. you learn how precious life is.
That's beautiful. Can you talk in terms of, you were about to retire, I read, but you did The Masked Singer.
Yeah, my friend said, get out of bed. I think it was 7 months after I fell, and I still couldn't walk. I was on the walker and on a little morphine at that time for the pain. And if you look closely, when they put that cat head on me, when Nick Cannon is talking, I had taken the morphine, and you can see the cat head kind of go over to the side. But my friends encouraged me to get up out of bed and go do something I loved. So they bolted me down to the floor. If you'll see, you didn't see me walk. I was singing mostly from my torso and moving around my torso, but I still couldn't move my legs. And the second song, they bolted the microphone to the floor, so I never let it go, unable to walk. And then they called me for American Idol, where I'm able to do my high kick again. And that was the goal, to get that high kick back up in the air.
You've played so many, many roles. Anything that stands out to you that you love the most, one of your most famous roles?
Well, my most famous, well, let's say, my favorite, my favorite is Jackie's Back. As a matter of fact, in 4 days, I think, is Jackie Washington Day. July 15th is Jackie Washington Day. It's a movie I did in 1994, and it has become a cult classic. But I think my performance in What's Love Got to Do with It, A Preacher's Wife, and I had a lot of fun doing Black-ish. It's been an amazing career. It's been an amazing journey. I look back and I tell everybody that my gratitude is liquid. I swim in it constantly. I'm always in that state of grace to do my best to be kind and of service. That's all I'm interested in now, is giving back and being of service. I got everything I wanted, Kelly. But my greatest success is I have a smile on my face 95% of the time. I'm still a gangster, you know. My nickname was Killer, you know, when I was in Kinlock. They still call me the Kinlock Killer, you know. You know, I was baby of the family, so I was a little terror running around, and my siblings, they love me now, but boy, were they sick of me back then. My brother Larry Lewis is over there hanging out with me while I'm home. He taught in the St. Louis School District for 30 years. He's retired now, Larry Lewis. And all over the world, his students, you were one of his students, for God's sake. They come up to me all over the world. He's more famous than me. I'll be at a mall and somebody will scream down, Miss Lewis, and I'll be like, hello, thank you. They go, no. I was one of your brother's students. I'm like, okay. You mean Larry Lewis? Yeah! I'm like, okay. So he's always teasing me about getting so much attention, but he gets a lot too.
Talk about that. How important is it to have your family supporting you in this business?
Well, let's put it like this. When I fell in Tanzania, I knew I couldn't tell them. It's too much. I was too far from home, just too far from home. It was too much to say, fly here to Nairobi. I was with my good girlfriend, Lori Petock, who I was traveling with. I was able to wake her up that night. She was back in her room. I had her, and she had met my siblings. So when I told them that she'd saved my life, they were comforted by the fact she'd been with me. But I couldn't, it was too much. How do you tell somebody their baby sister is in ICU in Nairobi, Kenya? You leave that. And also, the reason I didn't tell the press, the reason I didn't tell many friends, nor my family, until I got back to the United States, I needed all of me to heal me. There was no time to be on the phone, Jennifer, what happened, girl? No. I needed all of me. And I'm back. And I'm better. Thank you, God.
Back and better, what's next? Tell us what's next. You have so much going on. I have your book.
Ooh, what's next? Yeah. Well, what's next is the next book with a working title of Get Up. And it's all about how I got up. How I didn't quit. I'm going to tell you a little story that happened around the 6-month point of my rehabilitation. I was on the Pilates machine and I was doing the squats. And it was so painful. It was about midnight, because sometimes I would work into the wee hours of the morning, way after the physical therapist had left. That's just who I am. And it was so painful, I sat up and I started to cry. Oof, what a night. And I was thinking, I gotta call somebody. I need help. I mean, I had the physical therapist, but I needed somebody to move in and manipulate this leg and get me back. And I kept saying, who am I gonna call? Who can I call to really come here and manipulate this leg? And I heard myself say, how about you call Jennifer Lewis? Call who everybody calls. I think you got the number. Now lay back down and give me 20 more. And there's a chapter in the book titled, Give Me 20 More. Girl, that was a moment. That was a moment. So I said that to say this. The doctors, the nurses, the physical therapists, they will come and go. But you are left with yourself. And that's who's got to pull you through. They can only do so much. They can't get in bed with you and go to sleep. Who's gonna put you to sleep? Who's gonna say everything's gonna be all right? It has to be inside. You have to get yourself up. And that night was a breakthrough. You call on Jennifer Lewis and get the job done. Shh. Don't fall into that victim shit. Don't do it. Last question, little girl.
The last question is that it's so powerful, calling yourself. You had a message to St. Louis about this weekend, getting the star on the Walk of Fame. Tell us about it.
Everybody come out. Everybody have fun. I'm getting my star on the St. Louis Walk of Fame. Everybody's gonna be there, and I'm lit up about it. I'm just happy, grateful. Can't wait for all the pictures so I can put them online and share the glory of it. My siblings will be there, and that means everything to me. They have always been so supportive of my career. Larry, I remember you made that video of all my my sitcom appearances. My brother sent me a VHS of Different World, Fresh Prince, Living Single, In Living Color, all of them. All of my performances on those sitcoms in the 90s. He sent a video, and it's one of my prized possessions. So, yeah, my family's always been there. My mother was the oldest of 16. I'm the youngest of 7. So there's a big family running around St. Louis. And everybody's coming. And I'm very excited.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you all.